Tonight, meet the rescued French yachtie making money from his story, but determined not to pay a cent towards the cost of his rescue.
I think it's the ultimate selfish sport.
Plus, the ringing in the ears that can drive you crazy.
Sometimes it just is too hard to ignore and you just have to cry yourself to sleep.
Good evening, I'm Naomi Robson. Welcome to the program. First tonight, French sailor Raphael Donnelly is cashing in on his story of his rescue from the treacherous Southern Ocean. But he says he's unconcerned about the cost to the Australian taxpayer. Donnelly, safely ashore in Hobart today, is one of three solo sailors world attention has been focused on recently as the RAAF mounts one of its largest civilian rescues. And shortly we'll have the latest on those continuing rescue attempts. But first, this report on the bruised but unrepentant Frenchman.
Raphael, welcome to Australia.
Thanks a lot.
How does it feel to be back, huh?
Yes.
You feeling good?
Yes.
Solid ground never felt so good to this solo round-the-world yachtsman. Frenchman Raphael Donnelly, lucky to be alive after being plucked from raging icy seas in the Southern Ocean.
Has it put you off sailing? You would sail again?
Yes.
You'd do it again?
Yeah, I need and I want to sail in again.
It was this picture of Raphael Donnelly, stranded on the overturned hull of his yacht, that shocked the world and brought stinging criticisms of the dangers of solo yachting.
Very crazy, very, very bad situation, because the wind is very strong in the short tide.
The Vendée Globe round the world yacht race is one of the most grueling events of its kind. 28-year-old Donnelly wasn't even meant to be racing. He didn't qualify, and he lacked finance and experience. But he was allowed to set out anyway for the challenge, a challenge that almost ended in disaster.
And the waves scratch on me, and it's very difficult, and the night just arrived, and I'm thinking, if nobody arrives, it's not possible for my boat and for me to, and the death is next for me.
A rescue operation costing Australia more than $150,000 saved Donnelly's life. That, and a fellow racer, Pete Goss.
I wasn't going to leave him. I think you either stand by your principles or you don't.
You've been improving his English and he your French.
Yeah, well, I've taught him lots of words that will get him into trouble. He doesn't know it yet.
The pair have now spent the past fortnight making for Hobart. Donnelly's unexpected company shattering the loneliness and boredom of this arduous event.
Yeah, bloody good to be here. It's been, well, I don't know if you've heard, quite an adventure, really.
But all the strain ended late last night and early this morning when Donnelly and his Good Samaritan ventured into the calmer waters off Hobart. A small flotilla of yachts greeted Donnelly, the three life-saving beacons that guided rescuers to his stricken yacht, hanging from his hand. Ironically, after surviving this ordeal, Donnelly's first minutes in Australia were spent filling in immigration and customs forms.
While this early morning transfer and the simple formality of stamping immigration documents has finally ended Raphael Donnelly's two-week nightmare, for two other lone yachtsmen, it continues. They're still awaiting rescue in the freezing vastness of the Southern Ocean. Raphael Donnelly was lucky. But it's expensive rescues like this which has sparked anger and criticism about solo yacht racing from around the globe.
I think it's the ultimate selfish sport. You have individuals in their yachts competing against individuals to see who is the hairiest chested sailor in the world.
You've been paid some money. Would you consider putting some of that money back to the Australian government who rescued you? It's not something Raphael Donnelly is keen to discuss. But other competitors admit there are risks.
Well, I don't think they should stop. They do, you know, it's like any sport at the cutting edge, there's risks involved. But there's a lot of safety and technology goes back into the sport from these events.
Raphael Donnelly is now something of a French celebrity, having survived the race he wasn't allowed to officially enter, and he plans to sail again, soon, using tens of thousands of dollars paid for interviews by French reporters to finance his next adventure.
It'll be a great story, and it's probably worth more than $50,000, but he might do the moral thing and pay some back to us.
Next, a vicious racist attack. The terrified children who watched as their parents were brutally attacked.
That lady, she like crazy. She kept, you know, hitting and kicking.
On Seven's Comedy Thursday, have a laugh with Alan.
I know how to hang a picture.
Right, well, how do you find a stud?
Usually I just undo my top button and let him find me.
Electronic stud finder. Here? Nothing.
Then, on Almost Perfect at 8, the bosses have axed Kim's show.
It's official!
Only America will help them now.
You're not going to make me grovel, are you?
Have a great night of fun. Almost Perfect after an hilarious Alan. 7:30 Thursday on 7.
A proud supporter of Theatre in the Park, Caller in association with Big Burnout Productions presents A Midsummer Night's
Dream, featuring the Australian Top Fuel Challenge, with US star Glenn Vigors up against Australia's Graham Cowan, Darren DeFilippo, Robin Kirby and leading lady Rochelle Splatt. Plus, a stunning support cast of Pro Stock, Blow and Alcohol and Pro Stock Bikes. Saturday night at Calder Park promises to be a classic. Be there when the Top Fuelers hit the stage in round one. Curtain goes up 5:30. Calder Park, the centre of Australian motorsport.
Word is out on the streets. KFC's original Zinger Burger is back. Served with chips and a Pepsi for just $4.75. KFC's original Zinger Burger. Better get it while it's hot.
Toyota's summertime sale is on and all 96 stock must go.
You're gonna be a hootin' and a hollerin'. Yeehaw!
Stop! Get this! Vienta V6 getaway with $3,000 worth of extras at no extra cost.
Yippee-yi-yo, what a feeling! Happy New Yeehaw!
Hang on! 15-inch alloy wheels, single CD, aircon, map pockets, new fabrics. Go get a Vienta V6 getaway!
Yippee-yi-yo, what a feeling!
All 96 stocks must go!
Everybody awake? 40 Wings Stock Take Sale ends Sunday. Save 10, 20, 30, 40%, even up to 50%. Biggest sale, biggest savings. Hurry, 40 Wings Stock Take Sale ends Sunday.
Would you be happier if your family ate less fat? Would you like to take some sugar out of their breakfasts? As well as get rid of some salt from their diet? Well, if you'd rather your family enjoyed good-tasting nutrition and natural energy, you really can't do better than Weet-Bix. Real food from Sanitarium.
It was a senseless racist bashing. During the vicious attack, four terrified children huddled inside their family car watching helplessly as their parents were bashed by two other motorists. A man and a young woman abused, then punched the couple at a service station. The only motive for the assault? The family are Vietnamese.
Yes?
They both attacked me at the same time. She kept hitting me and shouting, say something very rude. She ran to me, she wanted to hit me again. At the time her boyfriend stood aside, didn't want to do anything else. But that lady, she like crazy.
Lloyd Dow describing what was supposed to be a holiday of a lifetime on the Gold Coast. But today, he and his family were back in Sydney, victims of a brutal racial attack.
When we all us in the car, she came again. She came and she said something. She said, you are not belong here. You are a crook. We don't need you here. You go back to your country. And also my wife said back to her, it's not your country either. She kept, hitting and kicking, want to make really big trouble.
The Dow family had planned to make the Gold Coast their home, but no longer. Mr. Dow suffered cuts and bruising in the vicious attack. His wife punched about the face and kicked in the stomach, all because of the way they looked.
At the time, she put her hand through the window, scratched my back and my neck very deep and very painful. But I didn't want to hit her back. If I hit her back in a minute later, I knocked her down on the floor.
What happened to the Dows is the second racial attack in Queensland in as many months. Last November, a Singaporean student was brutally bashed in Brisbane.
You use vulgar language, effing Asians, I'll go home, we don't need you.
He flew home unable to cope with the racial hatred. Angry ethnic groups were shocked by this latest attack.
They are actions of totally irrational people, people who still live in the dark ages, I would say.
James Tan says controversial federal MP Pauline Hanson is largely responsible.
I think so. I mean, it's very hard to put a finger on it, but certainly what she has said has encouraged those closet racists to come out of the woodwork and be more bolder.
Mr. Tan says while racial attacks like this one are isolated, Prime Minister Howard isn't doing enough to stop them. Prime Minister Howard has remained relatively quiet on Pauline Hanson's comments. Do you think he should have made more of a stand on the issue?
I think he should have spoken out. For some reason, he's not. Your guess is as good as mine why he's not doing it. But I think, as a Prime Minister, I think he should at least, you know, speak out. Almost every other political leader has done so. He has said something about it, but I think he's not saying enough.
Do you think Australians are racist people?
No, I don't think so. No, some are, but not generally, not the whole Australia is now.
Well, it depends on the place. I mean, I find that within the Gold Coast, there is sometimes more of a problem than anywhere else. I guess just because of, I don't know, what Australians find here. But I find Australians, on the whole, pretty much outgoing.
But some people are racism. But, you know, not all of them. It depends on people.
The Dow family is still coming to grips with the shock of the attack. Their dream of a peaceful life on the Gold Coast shattered.
Next, the $200 telephone bill Telstra tallied up to $17,000.
When I first opened it up, I thought it was $169, you know. And then I looked and I thought, no, that's $16,900 and something.
Summer action is back tonight.
All right, talk fast.
The show that packs a bigger punch than most, with more action than...
Dior.
Discover why it's become a hit.
What's wrong?
The Sentinel, 9:30 tonight on 7.
Michael Jackson. He's made history in Australia. Be a part of it with History, the number one album. Featuring 15 brand new songs. 5 smash hit singles. 15 greatest hits. 2 dynamite CDs at only $39.95.
Australia, you're the best.
Michael Jackson, History, remember the time.
And your breakfast, young man.
Kellogg's Corn Flakes, thanks, Gran.
Crunchy golden flakes of corn drenched in ice cold milk. Oh.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry, dear, we're right out. Abducted by aliens, they were. A gang of koalas broke in and robbed me.
Kellogg's Corn Flakes.
It's the taste that made me do it.
Side-splittingly fast, furious and funny. Melbourne's favourite comedians David Strassman, Chuck Wood and Teddy Bear are back. Don't miss the comedy event of the year at the incredible new Forum Theatre, corner Flinders and Russell Streets. Book now at Ticketek, 132 849.
Word is out on the streets. KFC's original Zinger Burger is back. Served with chips and a Pepsi for just $4.75. KFC's original Zinger Burger. Better get it while it's hot.
Australia's biggest carpet, vinyl and underlay manufacturers have given the thumbs up to a $10 million clearance. All their stock must go now. At Carpet Choice, it's the sale we've been waiting for. It's thumbs up to incredible savings on a huge range of floor coverings. Alco Australia's top brands at almost cost price. It's also thumbs up to massive savings on these famous brands and all on 6 months interest-free terms. The Carpet Choice $10 million manufacturer's clearance. It's getting the thumbs up from everyone.
Call your local Carpet Choice store direct, 132 008.
Opening up the monthly phone bill is something most people dread, and that's especially true for a Melbourne man who got the shock of his life when he received an account for almost $17,000. Now, to begin with, Alan Hayes wrote it off as a mistake until Telstra sent a second bill for the same amount and threatened to disconnect him if he didn't pay.
Alan Hayes is a bit apprehensive about using his home telephone these days, and with very good reason. About 2 months ago, Hayes received an expensive shock when he opened up his Telstra bill, and he saw that he owed almost $17,000.
I just felt sick. When I first opened it up, I thought it was $169, you know, and some cents on the end of it. And I thought, that's not not bad, you know. And then I looked and I thought, no, that's $16,900 and something.
Alan's first reaction was that he would have to pay the bill first and then work out the mistake with Telstra later.
After I settled down for a few seconds, after that initial sort of rush of blood about it, I looked to see what the breakdown was. And when I seen the 71,000 metered phone calls for $17,500, I thought, no, something's wrong there. In 2 months, I couldn't make those amount of calls.
In fact, the Hayes family would have to make more than 2,300 calls every day for 2 months, talking non-stop for about 6 hours a day to ring up the $17,000 bill.
Basically, we screwed up. I mean, one of our people made a mistake, and we've apologised to Mr. Hayes.
Telstra agreed a mistake had been made and told Hayes he'd receive a new bill with the correct amount. When he got that bill a few days ago, the bad news had got even worse.
And as I slipped it up, I seen your disconnection notice. And I said, oh, no. And I looked over to the corner and I seen the $16,900 and something again. I said, I don't believe this.
Hayes called Telstra again, was told the person who could fix the problem was on holidays. In the meantime, someone would try to make sure his phone wouldn't be disconnected.
The number you have reached has been disconnected.
But the Telstra Accounts Department has decided there are thousands of other Australians who won't be let off the hook. Earlier this week, they announced that around 100,000 people have to pay an average $50 each for local calls the company forgot to charge them.
We send out about 80 million bills a year, and only a fraction of 1% have any kind of issue raised against them.
That's not much comfort for Alan Hayes, a trusted customer for more than 30 years, who says he's always made a point of paying his phone bill on time.
But then I'm going to have doubt as to whether that is the correct amount now.
I guess we really do need to apologise to Mr. Hayes, not for only making the mistake in the first instance, but for allowing that disconnection notice to have been issued. That clearly was wrong, and we will be making amends.
While Alan's phone bill will probably be fixed, the way he'll look at future bills remain changed. He's urging other customers to take a closer look.
When you do get it now, don't just look at the amount you've got to pay and think, oh yeah, that's not too bad, and pay it. I would query the metered calls, query your STD calls, even look at the sheet that they give you on the back and see where some of those calls have been made.
And we'll be back with more after this short break.
I can go to bed at night and I just won't sleep at all. I'll have a loud ring in my ears all night and I won't sleep.
Are you ready for the really big hits?
Yes!
The really big stars?
Yes! Yes!
Then come home to the movies on 7.
Alrighty then.
No.
Hello. People are always afraid of what's different.
These are the box office hits. The superstars of cinema. Coming soon.
Tonight, when the Ryans of Bunbury enjoy a delicious beef goulash, they'll have been to the same butcher where the Simpsons of Ballarat buy their pepper steak. While the Shapiros in Port Lincoln get chicken Kiev from the same deli where Jack Armstrong of Robina picks up pizza for the boys. Fact is, all over the country, when Australians ask what's to eat, chances are it'll be something fresh, something different, something quick and easy from Australia's Safeway. That's why they call us the Fresh Food People.
20th Century Fox presents The Story of a Song.
That Thing You Do is the number 7 record in the country.
The band who played it and the man who made it all possible. That Thing You Do, written and directed by Tom Hanks.
Bob Jane T-Marts have hit tyre, wheel and battery repayments for a six again. Pay nothing for not only 1 month or 2 months, 3, 4 or 5 months. You pay absolutely nothing for 6 whole months. No deposit, no charges, no interest at Bob Jane T-Marts this month only.
Would you be happier if your family ate less fat? Would you like to take some sugar out of their breakfasts? As well as get rid of some salt from their diet? Well, if you'd rather your family enjoyed good-tasting nutrition and natural energy, you really can't do better than Weet-Bix. Real food from Sanitarium.
Take sale ends Sunday. Save 10, 20, 30, 40%, even up to 50%. Biggest sale, biggest savings.
Hurry, hurry, hurry.
40 Wings stock take sale ends Sunday.
If you can only hear me through a constant buzzing or ringing sound in your ears, you're not alone. 1 in 7 Australians are afflicted with a condition known as tinnitus. It can affect people at any age, and some sufferers even commit suicide rather than live with the constant noise in their head. Now, while there's no cure, there are ways of learning how to deal with it.
Oh, angry, depressed, cross.
I've had 2 clients suicide from it.
Sometimes it just is too hard to ignore and you just have to cry yourself to sleep.
This is what some people have to put up with every day of their life. A constant noise in their head which won't go away.
Hitting the wall, punching things so that help I can go to bed at night and I just won't sleep at all. Have a loud ring in my ears all night and I won't sleep, full stop.
Tinnitus is brought on by hearing loss. So many people think it's a condition only older people get. But that's certainly not the case. Toby Curtis is 17 and he's put up with the noise since he was 13. His nightmare started after getting an ear infection, which wasn't treated straight away.
Went back to the doctor again. He said, oh, well, you've got tinnitus now. Your inner ear's been scarred permanently. You'll be stuck with this for the rest of your life.
If that wasn't enough, his doctor put him on a drug called minimycin to clear up his acne. Big mistake. It's a drug which can damage your hearing. Toby's tinnitus got louder and louder. It hasn't been easy. Toby's had to steer away from things most teenagers his age enjoy. Rock concerts and swimming make his condition worse. Studying, though, has been one of his biggest hurdles.
When there's quiet, absolute silence, it's very hard to study or read or anything. As the tinnitus, you notice it more when there's no background noise.
During his tertiary entrance exams, Toby had to get special permission to use a Walkman, so the music would block out the noises in his head. He's sure it saved him from bombing out.
I would have made lots of mistakes. I would have had a headache by the end of the paper, concentrating so hard, trying to block out the ringing, then concentrating on doing the papers. Yeah, it would have been a bit of a shambles.
Music used as a masker, which is a technique for counteracting the noises of the tinnitus, is very good.
David McGrath keeps his Walkman handy. He uses it every day to help him cope with his tinnitus, which he's had for 10 years.
One morning I woke up and complained about the noises that I was hearing, and my wife couldn't hear them. So I said, the cicadas are loud this morning. She said, there aren't any.
David's 70, and it's not surprising he has the condition. He's a retired engineer, so he's had a lifetime of working with loud machinery and explosives. And loud noises are the most common cause of tinnitus.
Before I learnt to live with it, I got very depressed and worried about it. But since I was sort of came to terms with it and able to cope, it doesn't affect me mentally very badly at all.
David and Toby aren't alone. Barbara Streisand is another sufferer. And it's believed Paul Keating also has the constant ringing in his ears. Tinnitus is pretty common. 1 in 7 people suffer from it. No one used to talk about it very much in case people thought they were crazy. After all, we are talking about noises in your head no one else can hear. But lately, more research has been done and a lot more is now known about tinnitus.
Damage to the cochlea causes
an unusual electrical impulse pattern to leave the ear. And so tinnitus actually lives in the pathways connecting the ears to the brain, not the ear itself, which is what we used to believe.
Paul Davis is an audiologist. He too has tinnitus, so he understands what his patients go through. Over the last few years, he's done a lot of research into the problem and how to make it bearable.
Ear infections, ear surgery, you know, middle ear problems, explosions, head injury, whiplash, occasionally medication, anything which damages the pathways, anything which damages the nervous system can cause tinnitus. Work out what makes a tinnitus better and what makes it worse. And one of the most common things that makes tinnitus worse is stress. So stress management is crucial.
There isn't a cure for tinnitus, but Paul teaches people how to deal with it using tinnitus retraining therapy, where sounds are constantly fed into the ear. It retrains the brain to ignore the noise.
If we keep feeding the right sounds back into the ear, it winds the tinnitus right back to the point where people no longer hear it or have to strain to hear.
The retraining might take up to 2 years, but Paul says it's certainly worth the effort.
It really can ruin some people's lives, so it's very important to be able to give them all these different tools and strategies. There is hope.
I think the best way to handle it is to realise, well, I've got it, there's no point in crying about it, might as well find out what I can do to help me with it and just get on with it.
Well, tomorrow night on the program, a day in the life of some of our top jockeys. Are they underpaid and overworked, or simply just spoilt show ponies?
$65 a ride is just not enough to put your life on the line.
At the end of the day, a jockey doesn't have to be a jockey. He can take a job somewhere else.
But Ginty has raced to the lead past the 200. There's a fall, solitary note, lost the rider in the...
What would you say to people that say your claim's not worth it?
I'd say grab the boots, have a go yourself.
I've been up in the front of a field and knowing that I've probably got about 12 or 13 horses to gallop over the top of me and I'm really in the Lord's hands. You know, I'm at his mercy, really.
Call me King. Squad, go! Thompson's come down! Thompson's fallen in the home straight. One went over the top of him. Abracourt clear.
And we'll have that story for you tomorrow night. I hope you can join us. Until then, take care and good night.